South Africa is blessed with an abundance of wild animals in their natural, unfettered environment. They are one of the biggest attractions to visitors to the country. Safaris available in South Africa's numerous national parks and private game reserves give you the opportunity to see these animals close up where they belong, and to learn more about them than you can ever imagine. Thankfully, we live in an era of conservation. How very different from the early 20th century, when shooting large quantities of game was considered a sport. The animals in South Africa's national parks are well looked after by conservationists and rangers, who will share with you their professional knowledge and understanding of the wildlife. There is something special about the bush. The atmosphere, the smell, the tranquility are unforgettable and will remain with you forever if you have never experienced it before. Photos of Africa have produced this DVD guide, African Wildlife, especially to give you an insight into life in the bush. Superb photography is accompanied by a detailed narrative of over 20 animals' characteristics, habitats, and behavior, which you are likely to see on a safari tour in South Africa. Let this DVD tempt you to find the spirit of Africa for yourself. The lion is the biggest carnivore in Africa. Adult males have manes of variegated color from pale brown to black and of widely differing lengths and thicknesses. The head is large with a powerful muzzle. The lion's habitat is limited to the African bush. They are not found in rainforests or deserts. Lions are not especially fussy about their meat. They prey mainly on medium to large mammals, typically wildebeest, buffalo, zebra, and buck. However, they are also known to eat rodents, reptiles, fish, and even insects. Occasionally, they hunt larger species, young elephants and giraffe. Unlike most felines, lions are social cats. They organize themselves into a unit known as a pride, a group comprising females with their cubs and between one and about six adult males. It is another common misconception that there is only ever one male to a pride. However, only the males within the pride get to breed with its females. Male adults wishing to take over a pride challenge the males in fights, often to the death. Prides are a terrestrial squadron, like a self-defensive, self-perpetuating team that breeds and raises cubs until a stronger male breaks up the team and takes over the breeding. Most of the hunting is done by the females, as they are less conspicuous and smaller than the males. But single males have to fend for themselves. Unlike other cats, lions regularly hunt in packs, usually bringing down their prey with their claws or by suffocation, followed by a killing attack to the throat. Here is a pair mating. Promiscuous creatures, the female lions mate with all her pride's males and care for and suckle the other female's cubs too. During her season, a female mates over a period of 2 to 3 days, every 15 minutes or so. The white or square-lipped rhinoceros is the second largest land mammal after the elephant. This is a massive creature, standing up to 1.8 meters high at the shoulder, with males weighing up to more than 2 tons. The white rhino is distinguished from the black rhino by its broader muzzle and wide lips. Here is a female with her calf typically at her foot. Cows are ferociously protective of their young and will charge to protect them. The mature bulls tend to be solitary and territorial, marking out their territory with their feces. When meeting submissive neighbors at their boundaries, they rub horns amicably. Fights usually occur over territorial disputes and females. Rhinos have developed an extraordinary thick skin to provide protection from lethal horn sparring. Rhinos need grassland to survive. They are heavy grazers, combined with water. They prefer a flat habitat and plenty of cover for protection. They spend 50% of the day grazing on fresh grass and drink water in the afternoon and night. As you can see, they also eat soil for its minerals. These rhinos are mud bathing to provide protection from ticks and other parasites, and to keep their skin cool in the sweltering tropical heat of Kruger National Park. You will notice that the female's horns are shorter than the bull's. Rhinos can live to a venerable 40 to 45 years. They've been heavily poached throughout history, mainly for their horns. And conservation programs and patrolling operations have been very instrumental in protecting them in the second half of the 20th century from near extinction in southern Africa. Today, there are several thousand white rhinos in Kruger National Park and Umfolozi-Kluwe, and their numbers are increasing. The other cat of the Big Five, the leopard's distinguishing black spots, are grouped in clusters of rosettes, unlike the cheetah's individual spots. Adaptable and resilient, leopards are able to survive in a wide range of varying habitats and live right across South Africa, even not far from urban areas and in and around farmland, as well as arid zones. This leopard, filmed in the Kruger National Park, has taken its prey high into a marula tree to eat it without being harassed by scavengers. They eat and hunt anything, from small rodents to larger antelope, reptiles, fish, primates, and birds, depending on the habitat. Interestingly for a cat, they also eat fruit. They hunt principally at night, but during daytime too, especially where good cover is afforded, by stalking to within 10 meters of the prey, followed by a short chase and a pounce to kill, delivered by a bite to the skull, neck, or throat. The leopard is a solitary cat, unlike the lion. Both sexes mark out a territory with urine. The male's territory overlaps the female territories, allowing him privileged access to the females for mating, and vice versa, the female's access to the male's food. These are African buffalo, the fourth of the Big Five. Much like thick-set, heavily built cattle in appearance, buffalo have characteristic horns. Thick, wrinkled bosses across the forehead, from which the horns protrude sideways and downwards, curving upwards to the tips. These are large, bulky animals that need to eat a lot, almost 20 kilograms per day of protein-rich grasses, preferably, and other greenery. Buffalo are sensitive to heat and need plenty of water. Here they are enjoying a watering hole, drinking and wallowing to cool off in the afternoon heat. They often need a drink twice a day and need habitats that have plenty of rainfall. As well as the cooling effect, wallowing is also part of the buffalo's social activity, a way of spending time with other members of the herd. Buffalo have a herding instinct and commonly form herds of several hundred or more, which congregate in winter and break up in summer. If threatened, the herd bunches up closely with cows and calves in the middle for protection from predators, mainly lions and hyenas. Buffalo also observe smaller family groups of related cows and their calves. The older the male, the further he moves up the hierarchy ranking and earns a prime position at the front of the herd where the risk of predation is reduced. The huge African elephant, everyone's unchallenged safari favorite, our gentle giant, needs no description to recognize it. A few rudimentary elephant facts. The male African elephant grows up to 3.5 meters high at the shoulder and weighs up to 6 tons. Needs over 100 kilograms of food a day just to stay alive, and needs to eat for 18 hours a day. Males are noticeably larger than the females and about twice as heavy. Not all adults have tusks, and some only have one. Elephants like to live in habitats providing ample grazing, water and shade, such as grassland, riversides, tree savanna and light woodland, where they feed on virtually any and every plant material available. Grass, leaves, roots, seeds, fruit, bark and wood. They are dependent on water. Adult males drink 120 liters a day, but if it is not in their proximity, they will cover great distances in search of water and can survive for 3 to 4 days without it. Elephants drink by sucking about 4 liters of water into the trunk and transferring it into the mouth. Life expectancy is up to 60 years. Here, the elephants are mud wallowing and drinking. Females are seen here walking with their calves and suckling. The calves are very carefully protected by their mothers and the other females, who stay together bonded in a strong female family group. Elephants are highly social animals. Groups of up to 10 related females stick together in a family with their calves, led by the oldest cow, known as the matriarch. Such groups join with others to form large herds. The males leave the family in their early teens. In the cut and thrust of nature, elephants find time to show a remarkable concern for their fellow creatures, and even appear to mourn for their dead. They are also very clever and versatile communicators, using a combination of touch, smell, sight, sound, and posture to convey their message. But perhaps the most interesting facet of elephants' communicational apparatus is the vast range of vocal sounds that they can emit, most of which are inaudible to humans. Dust is deftly applied to the skin for for protection from ticks and flies. The elephant population in South Africa is secure today, to the point that there is an overpopulation crisis in some areas. This type of zebra is the Burchell zebra or plain zebra, found in the northern regions of South Africa. You can see that the stripes run onto the belly and right around the abdomen, and the stripes fade on the lower legs. It can be mistaken for other subspecies of zebra, such as the mountain zebra, whose striping configuration is different. Burchell's is also slightly larger than the mountain zebra. Although there are general differences in the striping that distinguish zebra subspecies, it is also a fact that each zebra has its own unique pattern, and no two are identical. It is a theory that the stripes may help other zebras to spot one that is being attacked and pulled away from the herd during a night hunt when visibility is poor. Their main predators are lion, hyena, leopards, and cheetahs. Herds of zebra like this one can cover huge distances in search of good grazing. Zebras are family animals. A stallion will have a breeding herd of 4 or 5 mares, which he controls and defends aggressively. Single foals are born. Most are born in the summer season. The foals can walk within minutes of birth and run after an hour. Zebras prefer to eat short grass and need a plentiful grazing supply. They also eat leaves and twigs. They are very dependent on a ready supply of water. These are blue wildebeest, a member of the antelope family and very common across northern, central and northwestern South Africa, although their migratory habits have been restricted by fencing. Waterbuck, distinguishable by their round white ring on the rump, are stocky, shaggy-haired antelopes. They prefer well-watered habitats such as floodplains or grassland, close to water, hence their name. As well as grass, they also like to eat marula tree fruit. They usually stay in herds of about a dozen and are easily preyed upon by large carnivores. Females form into herds with their young. Young males form bachelor herds until they become mature and territorial. The adult bulls are very territorial and defend territory by fighting often to the death with aggressive male intruders, lowering their heads, indicating a threatening intention. The warthog's so-called warts are these lumps that you can see here beneath each eye. The males also possess a second set of warts further down on the snout. Not just a pretty face, the warts also have a function. When male hogs are competing for a sow's attention, they wrestle head to head. The knobbly warts act as protection from the blows of his adversary's tusks. Maturing animals develop prominent tusks that flare upwards and outwards, above the snout, giving these pigs a thoroughly menacing appearance. The males have larger tusks and broader, heavier heads than the sows. Because the neck is so short, warthogs feed on their knees, using the snout and tusks in combination to root around for food. Warthogs like grass but are generally omnivorous, eating fruit, seeds, roots, and small animals. A young hog is a suckling. Litters of usually 3 to 6 are born during the summer months. The young are weaned by 6 months. The piglets fall prey to a large range of carnivores, as well as large birds of prey and snakes. The adult hog's main predators are lions and hyenas. Springbok have distinctively coloured hides, cinnamon upper body and white belly and underside, with a dark brown stripe along the flank. Desert antelope, springbok live in the arid Karoo and dry semi-desert regions of the Cape. These springbok rams are filmed in the Kalahari. They are marking out their territory with their horns and applying their scent to warn other males to keep away. The rams will fight fiercely over territorial rights to the best females for breeding, locking horns and wrestling. This often results in injury, making them more prone to prey, or sometimes death. Here is the male. Note the majestically shaped horns. Their most distinctive behavior, from which they derive their name, is a springing jump up to 2 meters high. They also have a fast, bouncy gait when they run, taking long leaps that carry them up to 3 meters into the air whilst reaching speeds of over 80 kilometers an hour. The agitated jumping is probably to signal the presence of a predator to the rest of the herd. These lightly framed slender primates are found in a wide variety of African woodland and tree savanna, but like all monkeys, are dependent on water. As well as plants found in the bush, vervet monkeys eat very small animals, insects and birds' eggs. Common and resilient, they are not endangered. Highly sociable, they bond together in a troop, a female-dominated unit of around 20 or 30 into which the females are born. The males leave this group as they begin to mature and join other troops for a period of time before moving on to another. The high-ranking males get to breed with females in the group. This cub is playing in a tree where later it will spend the night for protection. Kudu densely populate the bushveld regions and savanna woodland of southern Africa. They are present in large volumes in the Kruger National Park, which provides ample plant life for their feeding. However, they are vulnerable to anthrax. Single calves are born through the summer. The kudu's lifespan is 15 years. Adult bulls live solitarily, or are found in small bachelor groups, but interestingly, are not territorial. Dominance among the males for mating is demonstrated primarily by their size and aggressive posturing, but they rarely fight over mating rights. Kudu cows and their calves form family units, which the young males leave at 3 years. They are prey to mainly wild dogs and hyena. When fleeing, they raise the tail to expose its white underside. This acts as an alarm signal to others in the herd. This medium-sized canine is found almost everywhere in southern Africa except thick forests, which it shuns. It has an omnivorous, unfussy diet that varies depending on its location. In the bush, it eats rodents, small antelope, reptiles, birds, insects, and the like. In coastal areas, jackals scavenge on fish and seals. They eat fruit for its water content. Mating pairs remain together for life, although jackals are usually seen alone. While jackals hunt, they also frequently scavenge off carrion, inviting themselves on a meal of a carcass killed by larger carnivores. This is one of the most commonly found buck in the Kruger National Park. Impala have an unmistakable shiny hide, rich brown on the top, sandy on the lower side, and white undersides, black and white markings over the rump. They graze selectively, preferring grass when available, but also eat other plant materials, including flowers and bark. They live in smallish herds, like the one shown here, of up to about 20. But these herds group with others in search of grazing and water sources. Impala are extraordinarily territorial and defensive. Sexually active males are aggressive and fight frequently over mating to drive other males out of their territories, which they mark out and display carefully with their scent glands and droppings. In fact, the territory-holding rams devote so much of their time and energy to defending their dominance that they can forget to feed, become ill, and fall easy victims to invading males. When a breeding herd passes through male territories, the male herds the respective females, often aggressively and with the use of their horns, to prevent their escape, and mates before allowing her to leave. Impala are hunted in voluminous quantities by a large number of predators, especially wild dogs, cheetah, lion, leopard, and hyena. Protection from such animals is provided by a guard, one of the herd members, who can raise the alarm at an approaching predator. Impala have special alarm glands, when a herd is threatened, that release an airborne scent that provides an escape trail to help other impala. The spotted hyena, like a heavily built dog with powerful forequarters, is designed for living in the wild and thrives in conservation areas where they can find plenty of prey. Otherwise, they've been driven to virtual extinction across southern Africa. The hyena shown here has distinctive dark spots that fade with age, distinguishing it from the other subspecies, the brown hyena. This dog's preferred diet is medium-sized prey, such as impala, wildebeest, gemsbok, other buck, and zebra. But it will eat virtually any living creature that it safely can. Hyenas both hunt and scavenge for their food, like the jackal we saw previously. These are powerful animals with great stamina. They kill by disemboweling their prey, often after a protracted chase of speeds of over 50 kilometers an hour. Hyena make dens in caves and animal holes where they take protection and rest. They are active at night and can travel up to 70 kilometers in one journey. During the day, they rest in the shade and are often seen cooling in the water. They are social animals and remain in clans with a core of females. The clans are territorial and marked out by scent glands and droppings. The females dominate in this species. The males are the submissive sex. The hippo is a truly fascinating creature. The male hippo stands at about 1.5 meters tall and has been known to weigh up to 2 tons. Every schoolchild knows that hippos need fresh water in which to fully submerge and support this huge mass. The water also needs to be drinkable, and their preferred feeding places are within 1 to 2 kilometres of good water that is at least 1.5 metres deep. They can swim on the water's surface or underneath, remaining submerged for up to 6 minutes. Nostrils and ears can be closed to prevent water ingress. This yawn, where the hippo displays the tusks, is a sign of dominance and a signal to intruders to keep away. At dusk, hippos leave the water to graze through the night. 99% of their food intake is fresh grass, yet hippos don't actually eat as much as you might expect given their huge body size, approximately 12 kilograms a day. Hippos give the impression of looking a lot more docile than they really are. But beware, they are officially classified as the most dangerous mammals on the African continent. Stay away from hippos and take extreme care if planning to view them. Male giraffes in the southern African lowveld stand at 5.5 meters at head height. They are larger than the females and have 2 felt-like horns which are thicker. The front legs are straddled with the knees bent to reach down and drink water. In this position, the giraffe is very vulnerable. They only drink if water is available, but can survive without it. The mother stays closely protective of her calf. This mother-child bond lasts until her next calf is born, and the maturing calf has learnt the life skills needed to survive. Young giraffes are regularly killed by lions. Only about half survive their first year. These giraffes are feeding on protein-rich leaves and shoots at the top of acacia trees in the Kruger National Park, the most important source of food for giraffes. Twigs and branches are pulled into the mouth by the giraffe's long tongue. Small twigs are chewed and swallowed, including the thorns. They also eat the flowers and pods of certain trees. All is washed down with large quantities of digestive saliva. Notice that they soon move on from one tree to the next. This is because the acacia tree has a natural built-in defense mechanism. When eaten, the tree exudes a bitter chemical substance, tetanin, noxious to giraffes. So they have to be quick to avoid the bitter substance contaminating their food. The gemsbok, with its characteristic long horns and 3-colored hide, is a desert animal, adapted to survive in regions without surface water. They're commonly found across Namibia and Botswana. These gemsbok are filmed in the Kalahari. Gemsbok obtain their water by digging for bulbs, tubers, roots, and desert fruit. They graze principally at night, when their body temperature is cooler and the moisture content of the grazing is higher. Both males and females make full use of their long, sharp horns for fighting to demonstrate dominance. In contests, bulls sometimes stab backwards over their shoulder, puncturing their adversary with their tips. The horns are also used for defense, slashing against their predators, such as hyena. Long-legged and slim, these cats are built for speed. Unlike the leopard, the spots are single and not formed in groups of rosettes. There are also distinctive black tear stripes running from each eye, absent in the leopard. Cheetahs survive in open grassland, savanna, and also relatively arid areas. They are not dependent on water. They hunt during the day for small mammals. Groups of hunting males can kill young wildebeest and smaller buck. Cheetahs are the fastest animals on Earth, in the sense that they can reach very high speeds. The highest cheetah speed measured is 90 kilometers an hour. but they don't chase for very long as they lack the stamina of other carnivores. In the hunt, a high-speed chase invariably extends for just a few hundred meters. The cheetah then brings down its prey by tripping it at its front feet, followed by a sustained bite to the throat. Their slight build and small teeth makes cheetahs vulnerable to other carnivorous predators, including lions, hyenas, and leopards. So they seek to cover with their kill, dragging it from the field and feed quickly before it's captured by a larger contestant. Unfortunately, cheetahs are rare animals with only a few hundred in South Africa's national parks. The largest populations are found outside the conservation areas because they have too much competition for their food from the bigger carnivores that are so numerous in the parks. Conservation programs have meant, however, the cheetah is no longer classified as endangered. Southern Africa is home to more than a staggering 900 different species of birds, some resident, others seasonal visitors. Here's a brief selection of some that you may see while visiting South Africa during a safari. It is here with these beautiful images that Photos of Africa bids you adieu, hoping that we'll see you again soon in South Africa, a world in one country.